television. We welcome you to the 35th Star Awards for television.
And the star for Best Children's Show goes to Talents Academy IBC 13.
Presenting the award is BFDG Board of Director John Fontanini.
First of all, thank you, Heavenly Father, for this award. PNPC, thank you for this recognition. Thank you for recognizing all our efforts. To my AD, Justine Miguel, my Master Editor, Arkin Bruno, our home network, IBC 13. VP, Vince Rodriguez, Mom Roy, Mom Irene, thank you so much. To my artists, especially to their parents, maraming salamat po. You're always there to support the production, especially those lockdowns and pandemic. SM Cloudlink, Marketing, KCP, Lucille Grace, Lomi House, and to Attorney Patrick Macamay, and his loving wife, Patricia, thank you so much. We will continue to make impossible things to possible. Maraming salamat.
First, we would like to congratulate all the awardees for tonight, and of course, the award-giving body and the organizer of this successful event. We are truly honored to be standing in front of every one of you to receive this prestigious award. Thank you, PMPC, IBC 13, and to everyone who supported all of us from day one until today. Thank you so much, and we promise to continue to make everything possible. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, PMPC, IBC 13, Talents Academy family. God bless us all.
The star for Best Children's Show host goes to Anastasia Parona, Candice Ayesha Parona, Madison Gold, Gracel Joey Jimenez, and Cedric Ganola of Talent Academy, IBC 13.
Presenting the award is BFDC member Gerald Cesar.
Good evening to all of you. First of all, we just wanted to thank God for this prestigious award. We also want to thank the 35th award of PNPC, Philippine Movie Press Club, Incorporated 35th Award Television. Thank you for your full trust to all of us in Talents Academy. To Director Miguel, thank you for your tireless support, and to our parents who guides us with never-ending support. Together with our siblings and Talents Academy, without you, I can't receive this award, and we can't receive this award. Thank you very much, Talents Academy, PNPC, and IBC 13.
Thank you. Thank you, PNPC! Thank you, IBC
Welcome back to Talents Academy. Today, we're delving into the rich history and romanticism surrounding one of the most Philippines' most iconic landmarks.
That's right, Ate Nicole. We are here to uncover the fascinating story behind the ruins in Talisay, Negros, Occidental.
Did you know that the ruins isn't just any old estate? It's a testament to love, resilience, and the enduring spirit of Filipino people.
As more, Apica, what makes the ruins so special?
The ruins was built as a testament of love by Don Lacson for his wife, Maria Braga. Architecturally designed with European influences, it stands as a stunning blend of Italian, Spanish, and Filipino aesthetics.
It is not just architecture
that's impressive. The surroundings ground with its meticulously mated gardens add to the estate's allure and charm.
The ruins isn't just a historical monument, it's also a symbol of celebration and joy. From weddings to private parties, it's a venue cherished by locals and international visitors alike.
But amidst its beauty, the ruins holds a somber history. During World War II, it was set ablaze by the Philippine military to prevent it from being used as a base by Japanese forces.
The gardens surrounding the ruins, outstretching Japanese hills.
It's a perfect blend of nature and history.
The walls hold so many stories.
So much history.
It's humbling to think about all the lives that were intertwined this day place.
The blend of Italian, Spanish, and Filipino influences in the architecture is simply stunning. It's a testament to the creative and ingenuity of those who build it.
Made to protect our country.
To remember and honor those who came before us.
Despite the challenges it has faced, it continues to stand tall.
It's fascinating to think about the people who live here, their hopes, their dreams.
The ruins hold so much mystery within its walls.
The view from the ruins is breathtaking.
A popular spot for weddings and celebrations.
The ruins remind us that nothing lasts forever,
but the memories and stories we leave behind can endure for generations to come.
Hearing the stories of the ruins brings its history to life.
It's like stepping into a time machine.
There's so much to explore here.
The ruins in Bacolod truly embodies the resilience and enduring spirit of the people.
It is more than just a historical landmark. It is a symbol of hope and inspiration.
The ruins has witnessed the passage of time, yet it stands tall, reminding us of the strength found in love and perseverance.
today, the ruins continue as we take visitors from all corners of the globe, offering a glimpse into Bacolod Creek's cultural heritage.
Whether you're drawn to its historical charm, architectural beauty, or romantic ambience, the ruins has something for everyone to appreciate.
As the sun sets over ruins, we're reminded of timeless and worth an enduring legacy that make it a cherished treasure in the heart of Bacolod.
Thank you for joining us on this journey through the enchanting story of the ruins.
We hope you will continue to explore and discover the wonders of Bacolod's rich heritage.
Until next time, remember to cherish the past, embrace the present, and look forward to the future.
From all of us here at Ellen's Academy TV, thank you for watching. Goodbye, and see you on our next adventure.
Take care, and may your travels be filled with joy. Discover endless inspiration.
Everyone to Like Ko, Like Mo, Always Like Ka, the show where every story matters, where every journey is celebrated. Together, we'll uncover the extraordinary stories of everyday heroes, of those who dare to dream and strive to make a difference. Join me as we journey through the highs and lows, the laughter and tears of those who inspire us with their resilience and passion. Together, we'll bridge the gaps, foster our connection, and find inspiration in the story of others. So tune in every Saturday at 4:30 p.m. and let's celebrate the strength and success found in the lives of those who make a difference in their own unique ways. Kalaika at mga kaibigan, kamusta kayong lahat? Welcome sa isa na namang kakaibang episode ng Like Ko, Like Mo, Always Like Ka. I'm your host, Miss Like. Let's give a warm welcome to the talented actor and model, Kogi Domingo. Hi, sir.
Hello, Miss Like.
Kamusta ka na po, Sir Kogi?
Okay lang naman po. Thank you for having me here.
Of course. We are excited to have you here, Mr. Kogi. At the age of 13 years old, you joined ABS-CBN, Cybercada. Can you tell us about it, sir? Your humble beginnings in showbiz.
Cybercada, masaya siya kasi puro mga kabataan makasama ko. And marami rin ang natutunan sa ABS. And I met most of my friends from there. Cybercada was a starting for me.
So after that Cybercada, ano na po nangyari?
Nag-cross ako to GMA, then we made a Death Row. And siguro doon ako wala sa Death Row kasi puro mga theater yung mga nakasama ko and I think marami ang natutunan sa kanila.
So how's your showbiz career?
Roller coaster actually, totoong roller coaster nga talaga. Pero with ups and downs, marami ko natutunan and marami kong pinagdadaanan and make friends, pero sometimes you make enemies, but siguro in a nice way, parang friendly game na lang din.
Hindi po ba mahirap as a kid? Syempre kid ka pa noon, di ba? Minor. So nasa show business ka, paano mo binabalance lahat?
Hindi, Marte kasi talaga ako eh, kaya parang nag-enjoy ako sa Marte.
One of your memorable roles was, sabi nyo nga po, in Death Row in 2000. Can you share your experience more about it, sir?
I would say na kay Direk Joel Lamangan, marami ako natutunan and lalo na sa mga pagiging late and everything, yung pinakaayaw niya sa lahat. At least, nabigyan niya ako ng parang cushion na hindi niya ako masyadong pwedeng i-baby o anything like that, kahit na bago pa lang o ano, kasi mga kasamaan ko doon hindi naman nagbibiro.
So, Sir Kogi, how did your journey in showbiz shape you as an actor?
Mas marami ako natutunan doon sa Death Row nga, but with GMA kasi loyalty ko is with GMA dahil sila nagbigay sa akin ng break talaga. I tried auditioning sa Star Circle dati. I was too young daw and everything. Pero with Jimmy, parang may nakita sila and it brought out the best in me siguro. Parang ganun. I just tried to do my best lang.
So definitely, after a brief hiatus, you returned to ABS-CBN in 2019 with FPJ's Ang Probinsyano, sir.
Yes.
So how was that experience for you?
Masaya. Tsaka syempre, kay Direk Coco, okay siya. Bibigyan niya ng break yung mga dating artista, pati yung mga may edad na. And I'm very thankful sa kanya. Siguro madami rin siyang blessings ngayon kasi bait na talaga siya.
Pero balita ko, doon natin-test talaga yung acting skill mo, pati wala rin atang script doon, sir.
Wala, walang script doon. Oh. Talagang kung ano yung nakikita nyo, yun talaga yung ginawa nila doon. At saka on the spot lang na ginagawa.
At narinig namin na hindi ka lang pang show business. So, hindi ka lang basta actor, kundi isa ka ring negosyante. So, can you tell us more about it, Sir Kogi? Yung pagiging businessman mo po, yung tungkol sa yung mga negosyo at kung paano to?
Siguro kasi kailangan mo rin ng fallback dahil di mo alam kung hanggang kailan yung showbiz and maganda rin meron kang negosyo, tumatakbo yung pera mo, at least umiikot dun.
Paano ka napunta sa ganitong larangan?
Sabihin ako ng mom ko, ng dad ko, tinuruan lang ako na ganun. Nakikita ko rin naman kasi yung mom ko is very business-minded, yung dad ko rin, being a lawyer. Pero lahat ng analysis, pinasukan din niya, hindi lang yung lawyer. So it goes to show na marami talaga tayong parang nag-iiba-iba eh. May dynamics eh, nag-iiba-iba. Hindi man laging yun lang. You have to be flexible din, ganun, sa iba't ibang larangan siguro.
Mm-hmm. Hindi lang pwedeng dito ka lang. Siyempre, kailangan mag-try ka rin ng other
correct
things.
Mas maganda na rin yun para marami ka na na-try, diba?
Mas okay naman talaga yun, diba, mga kaibigan? So, that's very insightful and fascinating. So, Kogi, aside from your ventures and business, ano-anong mga hilig mo na activities na gusto mo talagang ginagawa para makapag-relax ka pagkatapos ng trabaho mo?
To be with family, siguro. Kasi yung time na nagtatrabaho, parang nawawala ng time sa pamilya. So ngayon, bumabawi rin ako sa pamilya.
Okay, so sir, matanong ko lang, ilan na po ba ang kids niyo? Anyways, very wonderful, Sir Kogi, that it's great to know how you find that balance in your life. So, now going back to your acting career, mayroon bang particular na character o proyektong espesyal sa iyong puso?
I like doing kay Anton Diva nung naging bading ako sa story kasi parang challenging yung mahirap yung yung manabit lang yung mga damit niya, mahirap isuot eh. Eh, hindi ko naman napapractice yan ever, so para sa akin challenging yung ganun. And to act at the same time, parang mahirap.
So, now for our viewers who aspire to be like you as an actor, any advice for them?
Just to be yourself lang. To be yourself and have fun. Pinaka-importante kasi ang hirap na magalito sa bagay na hindi mo naman talaga gusto gawin or like napipilitan ka lang for money or whatever reasons. Pero kung talaga gusto mo, parang hindi tatrabaho eh.
So maraming salamat, Sir Kogi, sa pagbabahagi ng itong call sa iyong negosyo at mga hilig mo. And it's been a pleasure having you here on Like Ko, Like Mo, Always Like Us. So sa ating mga viewers, mga kaibigan, maraming salamat po sa inyong time for being with us today. Mga kalayka, mga kapatid, stay tuned para sa mas marami pang inspiring stories. This is the show where every story matters, where every journey is celebrated. Until next time, paalam mga kalayka!